Greetings of the day students. In the lecture number 18 of Sales and Distribution Management subject, we are going to talk about two important topics, the compensation of sales force, and we are going to see the methods of compensation to sales force in detail. Let's just start it with the concept of compensation here. So students, the success of any sales organization depends on the achievement of the sales goal set for the long term or the short term period of time. While other programs such as the sales force recruitment, training, motivation are a cost to the company, sales force compensation deals with the management of the performance of the salespeople for generating revenue for the firm. We have already seen this aspect like recruitment, training, motivation. The last part of the sales management is compensation of salesperson. Now, the sales performance of an organization depends largely on the efficiency of the salespeople who are working within your organization. So salespeople tend to increase and manage their performances by linking it to the compensation they received from the sales organization. We have seen the meaning of sales organization. So a sound compensation plan will motivate salespeople to enhance their performances and achieve higher targets for the organization. Now, a successful compensation system effectively motivates the sales force so that an organization can synchronize its salespeople activity. So, the success of the system is likely hinge on how appropriately it recognizes and rewards such salesperson's efforts. So, when we see the definition of compensation here, the Filippo said in 1984, he said that he defined compensation as the adequate and the equitable remuneration for personnel for their contribution to the organization's objectives. While Forkes and Livernash defined compensation in 1989, they said that compensation as the payment of wages, salaries, including incentives, bonus payments and benefits to the employees in exchange of the work. So sales force compensation is number one problem is to confront every sales management. So compensation here stand for the monetary and non-monetary reports given by the firm. In return, given by the firm to the salesperson, and in return, salesforce renders their services to the organization. Through compensation, also compensation stands for contractual payments and the ad hoc payments too. Now, when we talk about all the important about the compensation, we are going to discuss why it is significant to plan or to make a sound compensation plan. See, sales force compensation is very important because it directly affect the attitude, interest and behavior of salesperson, and ultimately it will affect the nature of their task. So the most difficult task is how to reconcile the conflicting objective of sales, low sales cost and the higher profits on one hand, and adequate attractive earnings with security on the other. So both we have to look after the both the aspect. So in that sense, no compensation plan is perfect, that we know, but that meet the plan which meets the need of the management as well as the need of the sales force wholeheartedly, that compensation plan can be the suitable one for your organization. Now, if suppose we are talking about the good or sound compensation plan, what will be the significance of it? Suppose an organization is using a very attractive or the efficient compensation plan. The first thing first, that will attract the best salesmen in an industry. So there are some salesperson who are gifted or talented and they do have a high caliber. So they are available only if you are recognizing them or you are offering the higher rewards to them. And they will be come to your organization and they will be the cost efficient factor for your organization. Now you can keep your sales force contented with the good compensation plan. So what do you mean by contented? Contented means they will feel more satisfied with their duties. They will perform their job with more active participation. So if suppose there is we all know that there is a direct link between the payment which is made to the salesman and their satisfaction. So here, if suppose we are giving a good if we are offering something which keeps our salesperson contented, then that will there will be higher chances that we do have a retention, good retention rate in our organization, that will lead to the profit maximization and the goodwill of the firm in the market. Next is you can have a launching loyalty within your organization. So suppose the aim of every personnel management is just not to build the competent sales force, but they have a pool of selected person who are expected to serve lifetime for the nourishment and nourishment of the organization, right? So loyal and trustworthy staff makes the organization rich or dependable and successful. So here we can suppose you do have a sound compensation plan, then that will help you to launch that loyalty of employees or the sales force towards your organization. Now, next point which I would like to mention here is to have a sound employer and employee relationship. There has to be a sound compensation plan which works for both of them. So what happens is in an organization there will be bickering or misunderstanding or the drags arises most of the due to the money matter, and the wheels of that sales organization must not be squeaked. I mean, one such wheel is Salesforce, that will that can be kept in kilt if we paid off them very well and we treat them well. It is the sound compensation plan that will grease the squanking wheel for frictionless working, and that is why a sound compensation plan is very important part for your organization. Now let's just discuss the various methods of compensation of sales force. So we will start with the first type, which is straight salary method. So here in the straight, it is the most common method for remunerating your sales force. Here payment are made to the salesperson, which is called as salary, and most salary includes the basic pay plus the dearness allowances. So the salary is nothing but the payment which is made to a person for carrying out his job or performing his duties over a given period of time. So it is based on total time or the units of time. Like for example, it can be on daily basis or weekly or monthly basis. So spent on a work. For example, suppose a salary is paid monthly, weekly, or the commonly it is paid monthly, right? So maybe other duration of time. So salary is paid according to the fixed scale of pay. It involves a stable and guaranteed payment regardless of amount of work. So it is free from any business fluctuations. Okay,
The next you have is the straight commission method. So the straight commission method is the mostly income and payment of salesmen depend on the total sales achieved. So there are two options. One is straight commission plus expenditures. So expenses are paid extra. And the second is straight commission inclusive of those expenses. So in the second option, obviously the rate of commission is kept high, and in actual practice also commission is treated as a part of total payment which is paid along with the fixed salary. So pure commission method is hardly practiced by any company, especially in India, so that can be ignored. But the next we have is the amount of commission is calculated as a certain percentage of either total sales or the individual salesman has achieved on the basis of sales of particular territory. So company may prefer fixed or variable commission rates for different products, for different territories and for any level of sales. Unlike the straight salary method, it is also simple to understand and implement this method. It motivates salesmen to do a better job, and this method acts as a greater incentive for efficient and capable salesmen. Again, this method is a freedom of activities for the salesman. So he is not bound for specific hours of work in a day. So he can draw up his own plan and he can prepare his schedule accordingly. So he can act as an independent businessman. Now next you have is salary plus commission method. This is very popular and the widely practiced method to remunerate your sales force. So under this method, over and above fixed and the regular salary, a salesman is paid commission, which is commonly known as the incentives. So rate of the commission may be varied, or the fix may be common or the different to all the products and territories. So proportion of fixed salary and the commission depends upon the type of products or the territories or the company objectives and policies, or there can be a number of factors. The strongest aspect of this method is that it combines the elements of a regular fixed payment and an incentive to do the better job. So it satisfies both the new salesman and the experienced ones also, because all other selling expenses and the fringe benefits are paid extra directly or the indirectly to the sales force. And this plan combines again merits of both the methods, like straight commission and the straight salary method. The fourth one we have is drawing account. So drawing account is more like an advance which is given to the salesperson. So it involves the periodic monetary advances given at a fixed rate of interest or the commission that must be repaid by the salesperson to the company within a certain time frame. So that is for drawing account. Next you have is bonuses. So bonus are lump sum paid to the sales personnel for achieving the specific sales objectives in a defined periods. So the bonus can be calculated and paid on a quantitative or qualitative basis. The first, the quantitative one, involves the payment on reaching designations like designated sales volume, while the second is depend on the aspects such as selling to the certain key accounts to get a particular client base. So that is another basis. So it may also can be related to the customer satisfaction survey and all. So bonuses are the lump sum amount. Next you have is employee stock options. So again, as the name suggests, the mode of payment has become one of the most commonly used method, especially in the IT industry. So many companies in the US or in the Europe has been using this method of rewarding their sales personnel. Usually a certain number of shares of the organization are allotted to an individual as an incentive, and it not only creates a sense of ownership but also increases the salesperson to perform at a higher levels. The next you have is the special prizes. So here we are talking about the organization rewards wherein sales personnel organization rewards the sales personnel with the special prizes, either in the form of money or the valuable gifts like flat screen TV or the Rolex watch or the expensive dinner set, etc. So a special prize has been given or rewarded by the organization. Now next you have is special cash incentives. Yes, again, as the name suggests, they are these are given to the sales personnel during certain periods of time for performing specific activities for achieving extraordinary result, such as cash reward are usually not a part of regular compensation package for sales personnel. So the special cash incentives has been offered to the salesman. So I remember that by selling an insurance company, usually have this cash incentives wherein they do have the sales contest wherein they offer you some particular cash incentives if suppose you are bringing a policy of 50,000 premium in a day. So that's for that specific day, if suppose you are bringing in a policy of minimum premium of 50,000, you will be rewarding, you will be allotting, they will be allot you the cash incentives. The next you have is non-cash incentive. As they are non-cash incentive, but they do include the travels or the status and recognition awards or the merchandising. So if suppose the particular salesperson is performing very well in a given specific period of time, especially during the sales contest, he will be rewarded with this kind of incentives wherein they are free to go to travel for particular destination, or they are being rewarded for by promotion in a way of promotion, or they will be recognized by giving any award like employee of the month or salesperson of the month. Likewise, again, such incentives are given in the form of status award or the recognition award. The next you have is fringe benefits. So these are the benefits which are given to the sales personnel in the form of medical reimbursement on the pension scheme or the group insurance and the other benefits. The next you have is, which is the last type of compensation, is sales force expenses. So it includes the reimbursement of the expenses which are incurred by the sales personnel, such as a part of their selling activity. Like suppose it may have having travel or lodging expenses or the petrol allowances or the daily allowances and so on. So what company does is they reimburse all those expenses provided expenses in exchange of the bills which are provided by the sales personnel of the organization. So that's it for types of compensation plans of Salesforce. In today's lecture we have seen the meaning of compensation and the significance of compensation, what are the requirements of sound compensation plan, and at the end part we have discussed the various types of compensation. Hereby we are we ended the unit number 2 for sales and distribution management. From next lecture we are going to talk about the third unit, which is about the physical distribution. Until then, stay tuned and please subscribe to the channel of GS College of Commerce for the e-learning. Thank you.